Noah, summer 2000 and what? And 19, is that a new collection already dropped, or is that something that's new? Oh wow, okay, cool. So this is Noah, spring summer 2019. Let me get up here on the screen for you guys to see. Just get this up here, boom boom boom. So this is Noah, spring summer 2017 for you guys to see here. Ba, 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 ba. Should I get another screen up? Should I just do this like that? Let me just do it. So this actually, let me go here. Let's go like this because we want to get it all in, right? Boom. Okay, cool. So this is Noah, spring summer 2019. Again, Noah, there's no, there's no point even kind of expanding on it. It's probably one of the most popular streetwear brands out there. I think it's maybe the most popular, I'd say, day-to-day wear. I see a lot more people on the street wearing Noah hoodies, especially the one that came out. Did it come out at the beginning of this year? The Noah hoodie that's navy with like Noah written in like really big block letter prints on just above, just below the chest. I think they have it at the front and the back too. It's a really nice hoodie. Of course, the way they dye their hoodies, the construction of them, the feel, the quality is superb. Brendan Babijan, of course, is Supreme alumni, and some people would say he's probably part of the Supreme creative design crew who are responsible for some of the most iconic pieces of Supreme. I think back to that sailor jacket I had before with like the blue navy stripe, blue and white stripes going across. I think of the really iconic Parka jacket I had, red and cream, that Arjen Bondroth modeled a few seasons ago. I think of some of the amazing long sleeve tees. I think of some of the Wallaby collaborations. Those were some of the that was some of the peak era Supreme when Brenda was around, and obviously he went off inside his own collection with Noah, a bit more socially conscious, a little bit slower pace, more staple designs, less logo motifs and stuff, whatever, but just really good messaging behind some of the clothing they make. Especially if you go on the blog, he's always kind of giving really good breakdowns on what the inspiration was behind it. Trying to inspire kids to take action, whether it's politically, whether it's stuff to do with the environment. A really forward-thinking brand approach really for everything that he does. And again, I just love the unquestionably Americana feel of the actual collection, right? Because he's always mentioning stuff about surfing and skating, and everything I see from Noah just looks like something Brenda would wear, when he's going to go and surf in the morning or going to go skate and catch up with some friends. It just seems very much like him. And I guess like a lot of people would assume, most of the best brands that I would like or that people are fans of are brands that are a real reflection of their owner, of their creative director, person actually making it. It looks like an extension of themselves. They just, it looks like they're having the best time of their life just making clothes they would wear themselves, and by luck, the general public like you and I are fans of it too. So yeah, I'm a big fan of Noah, and I guess from looking on the streets of Shoreditch and East London, a lot of people are big fans of Noah too. This is their spring summer 2019 collection. They've reintroduced a lot of the check again, which I think was I saw maybe using the previous collections. A nice kind of like polygon, I don't know, print t-shirt here that would actually look really good on a short pattern. Oh, they make some of the best shorts. They're probably a little bit too expensive for my budget, but in terms of summer shorts to wear for festivals and stuff, I'm surprised I don't see more kids wearing them in festivals. They make some of the best shorts I've seen, honestly. And obviously, because for the most part, Brendan, I think, designed these shorts in terms of day-to-day wear. So they're not just swim shorts that you can't put stuff in the pockets, and sometimes shorts you get, the pockets are too small and stuff falls out. But these shorts are actually constructed well. They have nice deep pockets. They're really light. They could be worn, for some brunch meet or some friends. They could be worn to go to a bar as long as they let you in and stuff. But like, just generally really, really nice shorts. I think they're really underrated shorts that they make out there. So I haven't mentioned it enough yet, but definitely check out their shorts. But yeah, a nice denim jacket here, or classic trucker jacket that you'd call for maybe Supreme, that would do. Nice olive short there, a pair of Wallabies, not sure if that's part of the collaboration. A nice long sleeve top there with polka dot. And I've been a big fan of the logo just on the outside. It reminds me of like old 80s skatewear stuff. The little logo here on the outside, I'm a big fan of that. So similar to the little logo that Hiroshi Fujiwara sort of invented, that placement of the logo on the sleeve. I really like the logo just on the outside of the actual garment. I think Double Taps do a few of the bits and pieces too. And again, a nice tone. It gives just I like the colors, right? I just love the colors. In an era where a lot of people are wearing muted colors and blacks and stuff, it reminds me a lot of the color palette you'd see from Japanese brands like Capital and stuff. That's probably why they're so popular, and Needles. Of course, they make really amazing clothing, but just the the playfulness inside the clothing, just the color palette. So you even see with Cactus Flea, they make a lot of the same sort of, like, they use a lot of the same sort of bright color palettes too. Of course, on just standard designs, but it's something that gives that bit of a pop when you're using such bright colors. So loads of polka dots and stripes. Again, the styling is always on point. I've actually seen these trousers online in the store. They're one of my favorites, actually. These sort of like splatter print looking trousers with the navy blue hoodie, which is, again, it's a classic, that navy blue hoodie with a cross, or the logo hoodie with a cross here. I'm not sure if that's a coach jacket on the left, but that looks really nice. Cut the coach jacket looks amazing. It's cut a little bit shorter than a regular coach jacket, looks by the looks of it. Nice pair of shorts. Converse, one stars. I wish my feet were slim enough to wear them, but unfortunately I've got fucking clown feet, clown flipper feet, so I can't necessarily do that, but they look awesome on that dude there. I like this jumper. Oh, is that a shirt? A short sleeve shirt, actually. I like that. That crew neck logo print is also really nice. Nice little bomber jacket there. He's done this a lot with those buttons, isn't it? I've seen Brendan do a lot of that with those buttons, actually. At the back pocket of these. Where's that trousers? Oh, there. He's used those buttons quite often. I think in another pair and another jacket is also, I saw him use those buttons. I think he's a big fan. Well, whatever that button is called, I think Brendan's a big fan of those, because I've seen him in a few other collections. Again, that jacket looks awesome. I love the shorts. I think there's a brand. What's the there's a brand of shoes that they make, right? I forgot the brand of it. What he's a owner of, Brendan. But those might be it. I think they're Spywalkers or something. I forgot the name of it. There again, we've got some nice collection of t-shirts there. Nice pair of trousers. He makes a really good work pant. That's a nice little half zip anorak there. Looks really nice. Sweatpants. Again, wherever those deck shoes are, they're really nice, aren't they? Sort of like an update on like a Vans, Vans Authentic, but done a little bit, a little bit more panache. I really like the look of those. They look fucking awesome. Again, the styling is always great on the Noah stuff. You can't really go wrong with it. It makes you want to buy literally everything, which is probably the a good marquee of a very, very good, a good mark for a very good lookbook. Again, nice pinstripe trousers there and a matching jacket. Again, great shoes. The signature sort of like Noah belt. Again, nice shorts there to wear for the festival season. Tops again. Oof, those sandals are great, innit? I'm not a big fan of showing my toes, but those sandals look amazing, huh? Wow. And wherever those jeans, what are they, like chore jacket? Are they like carpenter style denim? Is that what you'd call that, right? With that little tap on the outside, would you call that carpenter style denim? I'm not too sure. Look really nice. Nice pair of red shorts there. Great color. Again, it's really hard to find that kind of tone of red on shorts. I like that with the front pocket on the t-shirt, and then the logo just below the little front pocket there. That's a very good placement. I remember my friend actually doing the same thing with his brand. He had like a little brand, and he put the logo on the inside of the pocket, so you couldn't actually see it. It was actually on the inside, which was quite a little cool application of it, actually. I thought, for the most part, probably a bitch to make, because that means you have to construct the whole thing and then screen print and then put the pockets on top. But you know, the details always matter. Again, nice pair of trousers, green shirt, like just amazing. All of it. I want everything in this fucking collection. And again, that's whatever. What would you call that? Are those cherries? Are little flowers all over it? It's a chore jacket too. That looks amazing. And it comes with the trousers too. So I think that'll be really popular with people, I think, for the most part. And the tone of those shorts look really awesome. They've not even been rolled up as well. So yeah, check out Brendan Babson's Noah Spring 2019. I think all this stuff is available now, because I'm pretty sure I saw the trousers online. If you scroll down here, let's check there. What does it say on the list? There's no point reading Hypebeast article, but sometimes it will tell you. But yeah, it's all in store now, available online. Noah NY, one of my favorite streetwear brands out there at the moment. Absolutely smashing it. Absolutely smashing it.